My name is Pierre Sylvain, and I live in Middletown, Connecticut, and I am a painter. I am pretty much inspired by everything, like music, people on the street, just observing people. So one of my big source of inspiration too, I will say it's my family, my wife and my children. And if you look at my painting closely, and you will see the resemblance, a lot of those women I portrait who look like my wife or my kids. But for that particular show, my big source of inspiration. So I have to go back to my roots, was the Haitian voodoo. So that particular work they are like showing, I am gonna be showing at the Hartford Public Library. It's inspired by the Haitian voodoo. I would say my style is like Pierre style, but because I take so much thing from so many different artists and I just put them together and make it my own. So that's mean I think for a lot of people, if you see my if you see my stuff the first time, when you see it again, you will know this is me. But I think a lot of artists who's been inspiring me over the years, I take so many little bit there and there. It's almost making like some kind of melting, like a spice. You pick something here and there and you pick it there. And that's something too would take so long to develop. That didn't happen overnight. So that's what it's very hard to really call my style, like a specific name, because I am still learning, you can never, you always learning, I think art itself, it's just a learning process. And I think as an, artist, the day you think you are great, that's when you're not great anymore. So that means you have to be humble, and start learning. I am always studying and learning new things. An artist, I relate to. I think I, relate to so many artists in different way, because my, dad always telling me that, and I tell my son that so many times. And, I said, when you have, when you see something, when you see someone doing something good, don't like criticize that, person, at least see what he is doing. Maybe you can learn something. So that's what, so in that, regard, every artist who's like doing something great, even like, they got so many artists who got like a lot of success, and I never criticize no one. I always try to learn something, how did he do that? Or even like some like technique, I, always learning. So, as far as relate, I am blending, I relate to so many different artists on a different way, so. I've been doing art since I was maybe 4 or 5 years old. Yeah, I've been doing that. And I always want to be an, artist. And I just didn't know how, So yeah, I, always want to, I always want to be like an artist. To me, it's like a, it's like a dream come true. Everyone who knows me, I always painting, I always doing art. So that's been a long time. Oh, that's a very tough one, you know, because I think even my, you know, wife always said that. He said, you know, every piece, it's your favorite piece. I think every piece I make, I try to do it good. Like, this is the last piece I will make. So for me to have a favorite, that's a tough one. I have to really look like, you know, very, very deeply, because, you know, everything, because, you know, if I don't like it, you know, I won't put it out, you know. So I pretty much paint for myself first, you know, and for, you know, and the rest for everything else. But yeah, so it's really hard to pick a particular one. Art is so much in my blood, you know. I cannot see myself doing anything else. So I always said, you know, hard to keep doing that, but not like give up, no. No, I never, no. I think what the best thing about being an artist is the fact, I mean, to me, I think every artist might have a different, you know, answer. And I think when you create something, and sometimes you have that, you know, vision inside, and you see that vision come out the blank canvas, and I think to create something, it's such a great feeling, you know. I think that's maybe the best, like, you know, when I finally do it, you know, and you feel that, you know, joy, you know, and that, you know, happen every time, you know. I mean, you know, it's almost like you know you get that thing every time you like create something. To me, that's the best part, being, you know, being an artist. Oh, I don't think there is no worse thing being an artist, you know. I think the only worst, you know, part I can say, you know, sometime my, you know, wife and the kids watching like a movies, so I am in my studio painting, and I miss that, you know what I'm saying? So I am not there watching it with, you know, them, you know, those little things, you know. And it's because I have to like paint, so they are watching movies, and you know, and I enjoy being with, you know, them. I think that's might be those, you know, I mean, if I can think of, you know, about the worst part, you know. My idea is just like, you are create some, you know, thing, and whatever happen. You know, some people will enjoy it, and some, you know, people don't, you know. But it's always amazing to me when people told me the joy they get out of my art. So that means if they have a purpose to my art, yes, you know, I think he gives some people some, you know, joy. So what, you know, ever the that, you know, joy it is, you know, but some people get something out of it. I think this is great, because I think that's what make, you know, art so wonderful, because you might see it some way and someone else see it like totally different, you know. And I mean, to me, it's like, I mean, you know, I see people who interpret my, you know, work totally different, and I will just telling them, I said, you know why, can I use what you like just said, because that make more sense than what I previously think it was, you know. So I think this is great. The advice I will have for them, I think I will, because I teach, you know, student art, you know, and one thing I will tell, you know, anyone who's like doing art, I said, you know why, first, don't ever listen to like no one. If you want to do something, just like do it. I think that's one of the main things, because sometimes you are trying to express something, but people doesn't get it now. so people might get it later. So instead of like, so that's the thing, don't listen, just do what you feel, you know, express what you feel, you know, don't let people tell you don't do that and don't do this. That will be my number one thing to say. But what I really hope the people come to that particular exhibit, the Voodoo Marasa show, and really enjoy it, because what I try to do in that particular show, I am trying to explain where like Voodoo, it's not that scary religion they make it look like. Voodoo, it's a religion who's about create community, healing, helping people, but not that Hollywood version of Voodoo. So that's what I would like people to know. So I came from Haiti to come here. That was 1991. And I went to school here. And I do different jobs. And one of the job I worked there for a long time, believe it. And I work for the insurance business over 10 years. And I work for Aetna first, and I work for Cigna. So I work for Cigna for 10 years, I think. Yes. So and so that's after that. And I always want to be like an artist. And I mean, even like I was working there, but I was doing my, you know, art on the side. And finally, I decided to go full time. And so I've been painting since full time since around 1997, 98. So, you know, since then I have been doing it, and I do shows, and I mean, it's such a process. I mean, it's like, you know, it's like a process, you know, you do shows. I travel, I show different, you know, places, you know, and I show in New Orleans, you know, and now I am trying to show in Washington, D.C., and so yeah, it's such a long, you know, process, and so I am still moving, because art, it's such an ongoing process. If I want to establish like a connection for me, came from Haiti and moving here with my, you know, art, I will say that particular series of painting, because when I was in, you know, Haiti, I grew up Catholic, so I pretty much grew up Catholic, and you know, I stay away to, you know, from the whole Voodoo thing, you know, so I always think that was like evil and, you know, all of that. So I am pretty much really what you call in a total. So I wasn't, let's put it this way, so I wasn't aware what a rich culture Voodoo was until I came here. Because what, you know, happened, one of my best friends become a Voodoo priest. And we were all grow up Catholic, and we all went to Catholic school too, to like a kindergarten to elementary school to high school. So my friend become a voodoo priest, and so we talk a lot, you know, about the whole thing. And so we've been talking, and so I've been thinking, wow, that thing is not the way they portray it, you know. And I feel, I almost feel guilty, you know, where like, how come I can reject something so beautiful in a way, you know? So that's what I feel compelling to produce that body of painting, where like I'm trying to retrace the whole voodoo religion. And one thing I, you know, did too, because if you know anything about voodoo, I mean, I am not calling myself like an expert on voodoo or anything like that, but what, you know, what I did, voodoo has like different loi, so it's like they call them God, and voodoo, it's really believe in, you know, God, in the what you call the supreme God, but they do believe there is a what you call small God. They, you know, call them loi, and all of those loi has different function, you know. For example, if you take like that loi called Loco, they call him Papa Loco. He's like the medicine loi. So when you are sick, you evoke him. So he's the one who know all the secret with all of those, you know, plant. So every loi, so if you just to go back to what you said, so that's the connection with my art, with you know, the whole connection here, because, you know, the fact my friend become a voodoo priest, you know, it's like almost he sent me back to school to learn about that whole religion, you know. So I mean, I don't practice voodoo, but I respect it, you know, and I realize this is like a religion, like any other religion. And I feel as an, you know, artist, because as an artist, I always think there is a difference between like a craftsman or an artist. So I think craftsman, what you do, you can make something very well. Maybe you can paint like a tree well, or you can paint like a house well. But I think an artist, what you do, you will take idea and you try to challenge it. And you want to people to ask questions, you know, you bring things on the table. Things, you know, people didn't see as, you know, art. You make them think it different way. So as an artist myself, so I feel I can bring that to the table and have an open discussion you know, about the whole voodoo religion. I think I have been follow what they are doing, and I think the library is such a great venue for artists, and because they give you a lot of freedom. I mean, they give you plenty of freedom. And I think it's such a great place to show it, especially as an artist, where you don't want to deal with any censorship. You know, they never tell me, oh, you cannot show that, you cannot show this, you know. So I think for any artist, it's such an ideal places, you know, where like to showcase anything you do when you don't have to deal with any form of censorship. So that's what I was like. I said, wow, that's really great for them, and you know, and I cannot thank them enough to give me that opportunity to show the work here.